Dear students, I am Shiva, faculty of physics. I hope you are doing well in your studies with these bricks. In this episode, we are continuing the topic Tarkan dipole with the help of key ideas discussed in the past video labeled as part 1. Okay, before going to start the session, I will pose one question to you. Try to answer this question with the help of mechanics ideas. What is that question? Suppose if you are releasing any object freely, about which axis that object will rotate. Please pause the screen 1 minute and try to answer it. Now listen the answer for that question. If you release any object freely, the object now start to rotate about an axis passes through its COM. What is COM? COM nothing but center of mass. How can we define the center of mass? Center of mass is the point where the total mass of the object is said to be concentrated. If you release any object freely, the object now starts to rotate about an axis passes through its COM. So in what direction you can assume that axis of rotation passes through COM? Remember, in order to describe the motion of the object about an axis passes through the COM, the torque vector you are seeing in which direction, in that direction only, you need to assume the rotational axis. Suppose here we are seeing some situations. First of all, here we are seeing one rod. This rod is what type of rod? Uniform rod. Uniform rod means for every 1 cm length, you are seeing same mass. For every 1 cm length, you are seeing same mass. Now, for symmetrical objects like the uniform rod, for symmetrical objects, the COM, nothing but center of mass, lies where? At the geometrical center. Okay, in the same case, you are seeing one non-uniform rod. For this non-uniform rod, the COM lies in the region where you are seeing more mass. Suppose, if you are break this rod into two halves, this is left half, this is right half. So think yourself, in which portion of the rod you are seeing more mass? More mass you are seeing in the left portion. More mass you are seeing in the right portion. Less mass you are seeing in the left portion. That's why more probability for the center of mass has a chance to locate where? In this region. That is the region where you are seeing more mass. Suppose if you are taking this board as an example. This board is an example for what type of object? This board is an example for uniform object. That's why where we can assume the center of mass of this board? Normally, if this is we are thinking as the intersection of the diagonals of the rectangle. Now, suppose board you can think, suppose 2D in shape. Then you can assume the diagonals. Where the diagonals intersect in this board, that is the only location of the COM. Approximately we can see here. What is the use of that COM? If you release the object freely, then the object now start to rotate about an axis passes through that COM. Now come to the case of dipole. Okay, so in this dipole, you are seeing this is negatively charged particle na, minus Q. This is positively charged one. Now, where we can assume the location of the center of mass? Negative charge indicates more electrons. Positive charge indicates less electrons. Nothing but more electrons implies more mass. So here, approximately the mass of minus Q is more than that of the mass of plus Q. That's why location of the COM approximately close to minus Q. Why? Minus Q only massive when compared with that of plus Q. This is the location of the COM for the dipole. So from this onwards, whenever you are releasing the dipole freely, remember the dipole start to rotate about an axis passes through its center of mass, then the axis direction is always parallel to the direction of the torque vector. This is also one more sign I mentioned, further I will use in my discussion. So this is the electric field.
This electric field, now what type of electric field here you are seeing? The distance between the field lines is same, as well as the direction of the field you are seeing always towards right. Nothing but this E1 is what type of E1? This is uniform E1. Okay. In this uniform electric field, if you are keeping one electric dipole, okay, at that time this diagram is equivalent to this diagram. Okay. So what is the difference between this diagram and this diagram? In this diagram I am showing more field lines, but in this diagram just I am showing only one field line. But remember, even I am drawing this one for the discussion, please remember this one implies this one. Okay. Just even I am drawing one field line here like this. Assume yourself, I am denoting now this dipole lies entirely in this electric field. Okay. Now come to the discussion. Suppose here now we are concentrating on the dipole. Let the direction of the electric field is like this, and you are placing the dipole in this manner. Okay. So what is the direction of the P bar there? P bar direction always from minus Q to plus Q. So this is the direction of P bar. The direction of the P bar is same as the direction of E bar. Okay. Now recall one important idea from electrostatics. If you are releasing any charge freely in the electric field, the charge experiences a force in the direction of the field if the charge is positive, and if the charge is negative, it will experience some force in the direction opposite to the field. Again, I am repeating, the charge is positive, it will experience force in the direction that is equal to the field direction. If the charge is negative, it will experience the force that is opposite to the field direction. Okay, come to the case. In this case, plus Q now positive, this plus Q experiences force in what direction? In the direction of the field, that is EQ. Okay, this is external uniform field. Okay, what type of field it is? External uniform field, what I told here. Okay, this situation is nothing but equivalent to this situation. Okay, students. Now, this minus Q experiences force in which direction? In this direction. Now, what is the net force here? F net is equal to, so this is positive direction, this is negative direction. Now, what is the net force? EQ minus EQ, that is equal to 0. Okay. Now comes to the situation of the torque. Suppose this is the COM. So now only we discuss now what is the relation of COM. COM always lies close to minus Q. Now what is the location of this plus Q with respect to COM? Now say this is R bar. R bar indicates position of plus Q with respect to COM. Now this is force, that is EQ. Now what is the formula for torque? So in the last class we discussed the formula for the torque is, in the last episode we discussed in this physical quantity torque. Now what we can write? Tau net is equal to RF sin theta. So where R denotes R bar magnitude, F denotes EQ. What is the angle between R bar and EQ? R bar rightward, EQ also rightward, both are in the same direction. Now what is the angle between them? The angle between R bar and EQ is 0. That's why here what we can write? R into EQ sin 0 degrees, that is equal to 0. Suppose if you are talking about this minus Q also you can denote with a question vector. Still you will get what answer? 0 only. Why? Here also R bar direction, EQ direction are the same. That's why here net torque simply what we can say? 0. So net force 0, net torque also zero. Now what we can conclude? When the direction of the dipole is parallel to the direction of the electric field, at that time the net force acting on the dipole is zero, the net torque acting on the dipole is also equal to zero. Therefore, the dipole is said to be in translational equilibrium while net force is zero, as well as in rotational equilibrium while net torque also equal to zero. Now let us come to discuss one more case here. Now we are placing the dipole in the direction that is opposite to P bar. Okay. Now again you are placing the dipole. Okay. In what direction? In the direction opposite to E bar. At that time, what is the direction of the force experienced by plus Q? Plus Q experiences force in the same direction, that is EQ. Minus Q experiences force in the opposite direction, that is also EQ. Again, you can calculate the net force as well as net torque. So, what is the net force here? Net force is equal to this EQ in positive direction, this EQ in the negative direction. Now, what we will write? EQ minus EQ, this is equal to 0. Okay, what about the tau net? So here tau net, now if you can take COM, about this COM, both of these forces acting in what direction? Like that, you can assume one position vector here from that center of mass. R bar direction opposite to EQ, R bar direction is opposite to EQ. That's why here what you can write? RF sin 180. RF sin 180. So either of these EQ directed opposite to this force at an angle of 180 degrees. Now here also what we can write? 0. Sin 180, 0. So finally here what we can conclude? Even you are placing the dipole in the direction opposite to this E bar, in this case also the dipole experiences 0 net force, as well as the dipole experiences 0 net torque. Finally here one more conclusion part for us. Even you are placing the dipole in the direction that is anti-parallel to the direction of the uniform external electric field, in this case also the dipole experiences net force that is equal to 0, nothing but the dipole is in translational equilibrium, as well as it will experience net torque is equal to 0, nothing but it is in rotational equilibrium. Now come to the figure 3. So remember this situation what we are discussing under figure 3, I am saying at the time t is equal to 0 seconds. So what is the situation? Now assume this is the direction of the electric field. Okay. So this is the dipole. So this dipole you are placing in the direction initially perpendicular to the field. External field is rightward, but dipole is oriented in what direction? Perpendicular to the field. Say this is plus Q, this is minus Q. This is what known for us location of COM. So assume yourself the total length of the dipole is D. So this length suppose we are saying as X. What is the location of the center of mass plus Q? From plus Q it is D minus X. Okay. This is what for us? D minus X. Okay, here our mind generally will raise one doubt. Okay. Sir, you are saying now, about an axis passes through the COM, dipole will rotate. And what is the direction of that axis? That axis oriented in this direction, or in this direction, or in this direction. In which direction you need to assume that axis? In order to find out the direction of the axis, first of all evaluate the direction of the torque. So how can we evaluate the direction of the torque? Suppose due to the direction of this electric field, this plus Q experiences force in what direction? in this direction. What is the direction of this position vector that we can define with respect to the COM? This is r bar. So superimpose that normal coordinate system, that is xy. Okay, now here what we are seeing, what is the direction of the torque? In order to decide the direction of the torque, use general expression for the torque, that is tau net is equal to r bar cross f bar. What is the direction of this r bar? This r bar now parallel to y axis, na? Parallel to y axis nothing but if frequently we can take what type of unit vector there? J hat. So J hat cross. What is the direction of f bar? Direction of this f bar nothing but EQ, you are seeing in the rightward direction. That's why we can take this one as I hat. This implies according to the knowledge of vector algebra, I hat cross J hat we can say K hat, but J hat cross I hat we can say minus K hat. So this is what the minus K hat. Nothing but what is the direction of the torque vector? Direction of this torque vector we can assume in this manner. Okay, so it may be going towards you as well as inverse you. Okay, so about this torque direction only, we can assume the rotational axis. About the rotational axis only, the dipole start to rotate. Okay, now let us try to calculate what is the value for this torque. Here also there is no doubt, na? Net force is zero. Why? This EQ acting in this direction. Due to the electric field E bar, now this minus Q experiences force in this direction. So this EQ minus this EQ. Totally here also, as it of previous cases, figure 1, figure 2, what I am saying, net force 0. In this case also there is no doubt, here also net force equal to 0. But what is the value of the torque? In order to calculate the value of torque, recall this formula, tau is equal to r perpendicular into f. Okay, so what is r perpendicular? So in this situation, r perpendicular value d minus x, na? So d minus x into eq. Here also, this is again one more EQ. EQ into X, R perpendicular, here D minus X, F reference EQ. Here also, what is R perpendicular? R perpendicular is X, F reference EQ. Now, what we can write here, tau net? So, tau net is equal to, again, what type of motion you are seeing here? Clockwise or anti-clockwise? Clockwise. For clockwise motion, torque is always negative. For anti-clockwise motion, torque is always positive. So that's why here what we can write now, EQ into, so put here minus sign, okay? So minus of EQ into D minus X, okay? Plus EQ into X. Okay, so clearly we are seeing that here EQ into D minus EQX plus EQX minus EQX plus EQX cancels. Now what we can get finally here, tau net is equal to minus EQ into D. So Q into D nothing but magnitude of either charge and the distance between them, that is dipole moment. So Q into D we can say as P, that is minus EP, that is not equal to 0, nothing but whenever you are placing the dipole direction, that is perpendicular to the E bar, at that time it will experience net force, but it will experience net torque, that is not equal to 0. Nothing but what we can conclude here. When the dipole is placed in the direction perpendicular to the field, at that time the dipole is in translational equilibrium. Okay, but it is not in rotational equilibrium. Why? Clearly you are seeing now here that value for the net torque is not equal to 0. Now we will try to describe the situation of this dipole after time t. Here we are seeing this is at time t. Now after time t, how we can describe the situation? Now say, this is figure 4, we are drawing at what time? At time t. Okay, so what we can say again, this is the direction of the electric field. Now this is the dipole. Okay, this is plus q, this is minus q, com here. So this is what, com. So as you know, the dipole length same here. The dipole length I am saying d. This com, assume, locate at the distance of x1 minus q, nothing but it locates at the distance of d minus x. Now here also say it was making some angle theta here. Yeah? Okay, so this angle theta, the dipole making with the direction of what? With the direction of the electric field. Now here we can visualize carefully. We can visualize carefully. So here this d minus x having its component in which direction? Suppose here I am drawing, this is the force experienced by this plus q in this direction. Na? Okay? So this is perpendicular distance. Okay? Okay. So this is the perpendicular distance for this force EQ from the rotation axis. Why? This dipole now rotates about an axis, passes through its COM. That's why the perpendicular distances always we can measure from the rotation axis. So here, how can we calculate the net torque? Here also net force zero. Why? This is EQ. This is also what for this? EQ. So here also net force zero. So net force here, zero. So what about the net torque? Net torque not equal to zero. Okay, clearly. Why? The dipole now currently under rotation. At any time t, we are assuming the dipole movement p bar is making an angle theta. Okay, this is what for us? This is dipole movement p bar making an angle theta with the direction of the e bar. Let us try to calculate the direct, the resultant torque acting on the dipole. So here, due to this torque experienced by this dipole, what type of motion that you are seeing here? Clockwise or anti-clockwise? Exactly we are seeing the type of motion here, clockwise. That's why the torque due to plus CQ as well as the torque due to minus CQ always negative in sign. Okay? Now, in order to calculate the torque, we are using the same formula. This formula already I utilized here, na? Tau is equal to R perpendicular to into F. Regarding to this formula, in the last episode, we discussed in detail. Okay? Now, again, in this case also, I am using same formula. Now, here also you can observe. So, this is D minus X. Okay? This length I am saying D minus X. This is now R perpendicular. For this force, I don't know. Say that when R perpendicular. Let us try to calculate this R perpendicular with the help of this triangle. How can we calculate? So now, in order to calculate it, we can utilize sinusoidal function, okay, from trigonometry. So by using sinusoidal function, here what is the value of this R perpendicular? So sine theta is equal to R perpendicular. This is opposite side to theta, na? What is hypotenuse? Hypotenuse now d minus x. So d minus x, what is r perpendicular? R perpendicular now for us d minus x sine theta. Okay, so what is the value of f here? This f now eq. Actually, in the last episode there I told you r perpendicular is the moment arm. What do you mean by moment arm? Moment arm is the perpendicular distance to the line of action of force from the rotational axis. What is the rotational axis for us here? This is the rotational axis. Already told you, maybe in this direction. Okay. From the rotational axis, we are calculating this perpendicular distance along the line of action of this force. this perpendicular distance along the line of action of this force. What is the value for this part? Same value also we have for this part also, na? That's why r perpendicular value here we are writing d minus x into sin theta. Simply to say, what is the torque into this plus eq? This is plus direction, na? This is minus direction, na? Now what is the torque into this plus eq? Torque into the plus eq, now we can write as, this is what type of torque we are seeing due to plus q, clockwise or anti-clockwise? Clockwise. That's why the torque is negative. Now what we can write here? Minus of eq, f value eq, that is this r perpendicular value. R perpendicular value here d minus x into sin theta. Okay. Now similarly, what is the torque due to this minus q? Okay. In order to calculate the torque due to this minus q, now again this is the line of action of this force. Now. Okay. If here is theta, what is the value here? Here also what is theta? Okay. So this is x. In this direction, what is the value for? What is the component of this x? Here we can see x sin x cos theta. So this is what again for us r perpendicular. In this direction what we can say? This is also x sin theta. How we can find out? We can find out as is the what we did for plus eq. So here also what for us? X sin theta. X sin theta also indicates what now? Momentum. Momentum for the force eq directed in the negative x direction. Suppose if you are thinking horizontal axis, x axis. Okay, now what is torque due to minus eq? Torque due to minus eq is equal to, this is also what type of motion it will cause? This one rotating in this direction, this one also rotating in this direction. This one leads to what type of motion? Clockwise motion. That's why torque due to eq also what now? Clockwise only. So now what we can write here? Minus of eq into x sin theta. Okay. Now torque due to plus eq this value, torque due to minus eq this value. What is the resultant torque or net torque? Net torque now simply you can add here, tau net is equal to tau due to plus eq plus tau due to minus eq. So substitute the values of tau due to plus eq here. What we can write? Eq into this is d minus x, huh? Eq into d minus x sin theta. So I am adding this term also here. There also minus common. I take this minus sign outside. Again we will write here eqx sin theta. Okay, now we can do a we can do this simple calculation now. So tau net is equal to what we are saying here, eqd sin theta minus eqx sin theta plus eqx sin theta. Minus eqx sin theta plus eqx sin theta, both are cancelling with each other. Now what we write here, tau net is equal to minus eqd sin theta. So what is qv into d? Qv into d we can say dipole moment. Already here also I replaced qv into d with p. Electric dipole moment already we studied in detail in our previous videos under the section of electric dipole. So one time go back and observe the definition carefully. But in this case, qv into d also indicates for us electric dipole moment only. That's why here what we can write? Minus pe sin theta. Minus p sin theta. Now from the vector calculus we know na, a bar cross b bar is equal to ab sin theta. That's why here also we can define this net torque, what we are getting in algebraic form. In vector form we can write now this one p bar cross e bar. P bar cross e bar, where p bar cross e bar indicates p sin theta. That sign now we can take positive when the motion you are seeing in clockwise, and that sign is you are taking as negative when you are seeing is clockwise. Clockwise torque means negative, anti-clockwise start means positive. Okay, but always slice the plane perpendicular to the R bar and F bar. Now let us try to understand some cases regarding to this expression. So first of all, I am taking here case 1. Okay, what is case 1? Case 1, now I am thinking in this manner. Here P bar I am taking parallel to E bar. P bar direction, E bar direction same. At that time, theta will become 0. Why? See here, this is P bar direction, this is E bar direction. Between P bar and E bar only, here I define the angle theta. That's why in this case, where we are showing P bar and E bar in the same direction, in this case, what is theta? Theta is equal to 0 degrees. If theta is equal to 0 degrees, you can substitute here theta 0, sine 0, 0. That's why tau it is equal to what we can say? Tau it is equal to 0. Okay? Suppose if you are taking case 2 again here. So in case 2, if you are taking the dipole direction, that is P bar, is anti-parallel to E bar. P bar is anti-parallel to E bar implies, what is the angle between P bar and E bar? P bar rightward, E bar leftward. So both are completely opposite to each other. At that time, the angle between P bar and E bar will become 180. So what is sine 180 here? So sine 180 will become 0. Okay, that's why here what we can say first, tau it also 0. Okay, means when the dipole we are placing in a manner such that the dipole direction is parallel to E bar as well as it is anti-parallel to E bar, at that time the dipole experiences net force 0, net torque also 0, nothing but the dipole is in what type of equilibrium? Translational equilibrium as well as in rotational equilibrium. Regarding to this translational and rotational equilibrium, already we discussed in our part 1 of that video, past video. Now let us talk about case 2 already over, na? Let us talk about case 3. So what about case 3? Suppose here I am taking the value of theta is 90 degrees, nothing but suppose I am taking P bar direction here, E bar direction like this. Okay, so this is the angle what for us? 90 degrees. Now what is tau net? Tau net is equal to minus P sine 90. That's why this expression will become minus P. Remember, this value doesn't indicate less than 0. Don't confuse with this minus sign. Here minus sign indicates about direction. Minus sign indicates about the dipole in the external electric field is rotating in clockwise direction. It doesn't mean this is the value that is less than 0. Okay? This is just talking in this minus sign just to give some indication about direction. Okay, now after talking about this case 1, case 2, case 3, in the last episode, we discussed three types of equilibriums based upon potential energy. If the potential energy is minimum means, that type of equilibrium we can say stable. Maximum means unstable. No change in the potential energy means neutral. So at that time I told, suppose if you are disturbing or displacing any object from its original position, when the object again comes back to its original position, at that time that object is said to be in what type of equilibrium? Stable equilibrium. Suppose if you are taking, this is pen, now I am displacing this marker like this, again the marker coming to its original position. So I am displacing the marker now, again the marker coming to its initial position. Nothing but marker is in what type of equilibrium? Stable equilibrium. Suppose if you are thinking any object, suppose this marker only I am placing here. Now even I am disturbing this marker a little bit, it will fall down completely. Then I was unable to make that marker to bring its original position without applying any force. That's why The markers question, if you are seeing in this pattern, this is the example for unstable, and you are seeing the markers question in this pattern, this is an example for stable. Now let us try to recognize what we are seeing in figure 1 as well as in figure 2. In figure 1 and figure 2, clearly we know that is that are in equilibrium, that is translation and rotation equilibrium. Now out of this figure 1 and figure 2, which equilibrium corresponding to stable equilibrium as well as which equilibrium corresponding to unstable equilibrium? Suppose here I am talking for figure 1, okay. So in figure 1 you are seeing the direction of the P bar is parallel to E bar, right? So this is the direction of P bar parallel to E bar. Suppose I am disturbing the dipole in this pattern, okay. I am moving the dipole in this pattern, okay, from this small displacement I am giving. Now how the figure looks like? The figure looks like in this pattern, now regarding to the figure 1 I am talking here. So figure approximately looks like in this pattern. This is plus Q, this is minus Q, this is some small angle that I am disturbing it. Plus Q experiences still, okay, after the small displacement theta, plus Q again experiences force in this direction. Why? The direction of the electric field also in this direction. Again, minus Q also experiences force in this direction. Nothing but it was trying these two forces, trying to bring the dipole back to its original position. What is the original position? Original position of the dipole is this one. It's clearly what you are seeing in the figure 1. P bar is parallel to E bar. So even if you are disturbing the dipole a little bit, the dipole experiences force in this pattern such that the dipole now coincides with the direction of E bar. Nothing but even if you are disturbing the dipole a little bit, the dipole again start to come to its original position. That's why this example what we discussed in figure 1 is an example for stable equilibrium. Now come to the figure 2. Okay, in figure 2, direction of the P bar exactly opposite to E bar. P bar is leftward, E bar is rightward. So in this situation what will happen if you disturb the dipole from its original location? Now I am drawing this figure 2 here. Now so this is dipole, now what we are seeing in figure 2, this is plus Q, this is minus Q, okay. Now I am disturbing this dipole from its original position. Nothing but suppose I am rotating this dipole in this pattern. This is again minus Q, this is again plus Q, okay. Dotted line I am showing for figure 2. This solid line I am showing to indicate this dipole has rotated by this small angle theta. What is the direction of the electric field? Direction of the electric field you are seeing again in the rightward direction, okay. So whenever you can disturb the dipole a little bit from this original position, at that time this plus Q experiences force in this direction, this minus Q experiences force in this direction. Nothing but this dipole start to move in this direction, okay. Plus Q experiences force in this direction, na? This upper part start to move in this direction, lower part start to move in this direction. Nothing but the dipole now start to rotate in what direction? Clockwise direction. This rotation will continue until P bar direction is same as that of R bar. Nothing but finally what we can conclude here, in the figure 2 you can disturb the dipole a little bit by an angle theta, the dipole can't be able to regain its original position. That's why this situation we can say an example for what type of equilibrium? Unstable equilibrium, okay.
So these are the two types of equilibrium that we can define for figure 1 and figure 2. Okay students, in this session what we discussed? We discussed about torque on dipole with the help of last episode prerequisites. So first of all, we discussed here a little bit about our mechanics, one important concept from our mechanics, that is COM. How can we define the COM for uniform and non-uniform? How can you define the COM for dipole? Later, what is the notation? Okay, later we are describing some cases. Na? First case, P bar is parallel to E bar. Second case, P bar is anti-parallel to E bar. At that time, what happens to the force and what happens to the torque? Later we discussed figure 3 as figure 4. Just we are concentrating on the dipole when the time changes from 0 to T, where the dipole angle changes from 90 to some arc triangle theta. Later we deduce some expression for the torque. The torque expression here minus P sine theta, and finally this vector equation P bar cross E bar. Later we discuss some cases what happens P bar is parallel to E bar, anti parallel to E bar, if both P bar and E bar are perpendicular. Finally I tried to mention what type of equilibriums that we have based upon the potential energy for figure 1 as well as for figure 2. I hope you understood this session well. In the next session, we will meet with one more new concept. Thank you for watching.